my advice is if you're finding yourself stuck or trapped or just like kind of, you know, you just sort of need a little jolt, write the introduction because I think it'll help you have confidence in where this goes. And for some of you that are really craving more structure, once you have the introduction, it'll really help. And so, you know, I oftentimes will describe it in this way. If you think about our sort of writing pace here, you know, you start out in the first, you know, sort of month, we don't do any writing, right? So you make no writing progress. You're like, oh gosh, 25,000 words, like I'm already down to like, you know, 16 weeks left. And so even in the early days of creating content, you see that like people create, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6,000 words, but it sort of doesn't happen. Once people have the positioning call, typically this is where things accelerate. So don't be surprised if you have the positioning call, you write the introduction. Again, the structure flows from it, and you can start to see how you can move things in. What you'll start to see as we start to move into this like structuring phase, where we're going to be moving into chapter structuring in the near future, we're doing these things, is you're going to start to write less sort of standalone stories, and you're gonna start to write pieces in context. So next week's session, we'll start to talk about how to organize your chapters, we'll start to organize how to like pull together other research pieces, and so what you'll do is rather than writing pieces kind of as these bricks and wood that we talk about, you're gonna start actually building your house. So you're gonna start to sort of do those things that says, okay, we're gonna frame this thing, now that we have the introduction, the structure of it, we're gonna then start to fill in, and again, the pace will pick up in that regard. So don't be surprised if you're finding yourself saying, hey, I wanted to have written more words, I haven't yet. Oftentimes, after the positioning call introduction, you see an uptick just for a bunch of reasons. One, deadlines drive action, but number two, you start to sort of understand where it's going, and again, writing context. So again, as you start to think about your introduction, remember, it is not just sort of the intro to the book. It really sets the stage, it's the document you're going to use a lot, and more than anything, remember, this is the one that you'll iterate on a few times. Make sure you get to a point with your introduction, with your editor, it's really helpful. And again, this is the one thing, there are sort of three big things we're going to be turning in. Number one, your story content, just the raw content, I'm not judging for quality. Number two, your introduction. Number three, the rough structure of the book. Those are the three things. The one that I will sort of spend my time on and give you feedback on is your introduction. So make sure you have one that you feel like is illustrative of where you're trying to go. Couple last things here. Take a look at the structure coming out of this one of your introduction. If you have something you're unclear on, the best thing you can do is take the structure that we have coming out of our positioning call and sit down with your editor and talk through it. Sometimes people will say, hey, Eric, could you talk through this part of it? And my advice is to not, actually. Like, we record it, you can go back through it. But the more important thing is you want to sort of, as sort of Juliet sort of illustrated, you want to absorb it and make it your own. So the goal of this one here is to give you some ideas behind it of how it should go, but the most important thing is that you can absorb it and then play it back in your own words. So if you sort of tweak things and change things based on what you know, I mean, in you know, 30 minutes, I'm only able to like consume as much as I can from you and play it back. But you know, play this back to other people. Walk people through the structure of it. Walk your editor through it in those regards. And then again, the book structure itself is another one to start to think through. My advice is, again, to sit down with your editor and other people and sort of say, you know, I'm moving some stuff around, tweaking some things here. Again, I think, you know, those are the things that you want to do to move it into a place where you can figure out where this will actually go. So I don't have any magic wand when I do it. I just go through and listen and sort of seen enough of these ones to help give you a loose structure. But take it, make it your own, and when you find holes in it or where things don't make sense, just remember, I'm not sort of any smarter than you, just that I'm trying to use a framework that I've seen these things sort of work in that regard. So that's what we have for this week. These things, have a wonderful Thanksgiving. Any last questions from anyone? Anything from you? No. Any questions from anyone on the horn at all before I let you guys have a merry, happy Thanksgiving?